Okay, good afternoon to you. Tim here. This is a weekly roundup for the Raging Mouflons, Pink Mouflons, of the sort of exercises myself and Michallis have been doing over the last week with some explanation. So hopefully you can make it, you can join us at the weekly sessions or the 6:30 sessions. If not, there'll always be a backup resource on the internet, on YouTube, that you can follow, okay? So let me just take you through it. There's two parts to it. The first one is the stood up exercises, the standing exercises. The second is the floor exercises. Okay, now, first one is star jumps, jumping jacks. Now I do it slightly different because I want to just warm up the body as normal, but also the shoulders and the hip flexors, hips as well. Now when we do it, your legs are either doing the normal stride jumps you're familiar with, or if you're restricted by height, then you can do high knees marching as well. Okay, with the arms, four versions. The first version is standard star jumps. That's working up what's called the frontal plane. The second version is one to the front, one to the side. That's called the sagittal plane and the frontal plane. Number three is two to the front, two to the top. And option four is palms down, palms up. Let me just go through that each. So, star jumps, jumping jacks, two, one, go. Two, three, four, option two, one forward, one side. One forward, one side, option three, two forwards. And option four, palms down, palms up, and we're coming out in that T-shaped star. Okay, now how you do all of these exercises, you either do the exercise for 40 seconds and off for 20 seconds, or maybe on for a minute, off for 30 seconds. That is called Tabata style. So you do the exercise, good quality exercise for a period, and then have a rest period as well, exactly what we've been doing. So number one, star jumps. Number two is lunges. There are two ways of doing this. We've been doing either forward lunging, so left and right, forward lunging, left and right, or you can do forwards and then back, okay? So it depends on how you want to do it. But if you kept it simple, forwards, forwards, and then changing the exercise, step back. Notice when I step back, I move my arms out to the front for a bit of counterbalance. You don't have to do that. Okay, so basically we're fixed in one position and we're stepping back, or the other way around, stepping back, yeah? I like to reach for, give me a good stretch as well. Okay, so I'm activating, but you can keep your hands down here if you want. Okay, number two. Number three is squats. Now the key to squats, if I just show you the bottom, as I squat down, I'm sitting backwards. I'm not leaning forwards. And the idea is I'm sitting back down on my heels and my knees don't go any further forward than my toes. So this is the sort of squat I'm looking for. Okay? The legs can either be parallel or what's called a sumo squat. Either is good. We're going down as far as we can go, comfortable, and then pushing up, forcefully pushing up, okay? Simply like that, easy, easy squats. Keep your head up and your neutral spine. What you don't want to be doing is leaning forward. So it's this sort of situation. I find having my hands up gives me a point of focus as well, or I pick a point on the wall that I'm looking at, and that keeps my spine neutral. Okay, so that's squats. You can also do a squat inside a band as we've done previously. You literally stand inside the band. Let me show you that. A typical band. So you stand inside the band. Here's my feet. And what we're doing, same again, down and up. Or we can hold it there, okay? So there's your squats. Body rotations, we've done this before. You can do it body weight, simply pushing around. You can do it with a band, over the back. We've done plenty of these before. And we're trying to move through 180 degrees. You see what I mean? But if you can only move less than that, fine. But work up to at least 180 degrees and try and keep those a distance apart. So it's not there, it's not there. It's that sort of situation there. So we can do it with body weight. If you had a broomstick or a paddle, in fact, handy, same sort of thing, moving around. There we go, body rotations again. So there's another one. The next one is halos. Now we can do halos with a broomstick or a paddle again. These are the halos where you're basically circumnavigating your head. Okay, you can do it with a shorter stick. It's about really mobilizing the shoulders, rotator cuff, and these deltoids at the top here. Also, you can do it with a resistance band, doubled over or normal length, same sort of thing. You can even do it without holding a weight. So remember, you go maybe 10 in one direction, 10 in the other, forever what period you're exercising or working, be that 40 seconds, a minute, or whatever. Okay, the next one is called a posterior chain stretch and oblique. Let me explain it. So basically, just get you in the viewfinder there, I'm going all the way to up, all the way down. So when I go down to the bottom, I'm just touching the ground, and as I do more, my back will loosen up. So the top end, we're coming up to a good natural position. Notice I'm not locking out my legs. I've got a soft bend in the legs. So I'm going all the way down and all the way up. Okay, that's the posterior chain stretch. The posterior chain is the muscles of locomotion down the back of my body. Okay, that's my hamstrings, that's my glutes, that's my lats, trapezius, rhomboids, and calves as well. Okay, all those muscles that I use to move me forwards. So that's the posterior chain. The obliques is a stretch that way. Notice this hand is not moving. I'm rotating out. Other way, rotating out. I can do the same thing with a broomstick or a paddle. So this part is rotating out, rotating out. So the whole thing is up, down, out, out, all the way up, all the way down, rotate out, and when I do that I can feel that oblique stretch. That's why it's posterior chain, stretch, stretch, posterior chain, stretch, stretch. You get the idea. Okay, next one before we move on is the kayak. Now this is basically, it's as if, imagine this was a double bladed paddle. So I'm pushing down, sweeping down, but I'm really engaging my shoulders at this point. Okay, pushing down, pushing down, pushing down, pushing down. So it's forcefully pushing down, but I'm swinging through the core, engaging the core, and engaging the shoulders as I do it as well. Okay, I can do that with a resistance band as well, except this becomes, if I double the band over, this becomes my paddle. So I'm going push, 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 push. You get the idea. Okay, the last one before we go on to the floor exercises, I call this a stork or flamingo. So called because those two birds stand on one leg. Two ways of doing it. The way we did it with Michallis yesterday was basically a straightforward balance exercise. We did it like this. You can do it with arms in a T-shape, or you can do it holding the leg. Get my balance first. Now, focus on a point. Then you can do it. You see what I mean? So if you focus on a point, so either no legs or focus on a point, and then it becomes easier. So if I focus on the screen, there we go. Now, if you're nice and balanced, you could introduce other exercises, leg up to the side. But for this point in time, that sort of situation, or that situation is fine. Now, what I showed you there, if I'm not looking all over the place, it's quite hard to get my balance. So find a focal point first. I'll pick a point on the wall, leg up, and then I can find my balance. Okay? If I find that balance point first, it becomes easier. Or, a little bit easier, perhaps, one leg standing up. Of course, I'm counterbalancing that way. A good exercise just to center yourself is actually quite a good iso hold type exercise as well, where we keep the core stronger. But like I say, we can either do straightforward balance, pick a point, focus. I'm focusing on that point there. And then from there, when I'm nice and stable, I can start moving the leg around and do various balancing exercises, which are all part of the flamingo stroke stalk routine. Okay, I'm now gonna just phase into the second part of it, which is the ground exercises. I need to turn the camera off to start with, so hold that. Okay, Mouflons, hello again. This is part two of the weekly roundup. This is the floor aspect exercises that Michallis has been doing with you this week, with a little bit of demonstration and a little bit of technical stuff as well. So here we go. The first one we're doing is the straightforward crunch. Now, it's like a sit-up. What I suggest you do is hands on the temples, not hands behind. What you don't want to be doing is straining your neck. So hands on the temples or out to the side, and the crunch is quite simply lifting up, engaging the abs. Don't come up too far, that's more of a sit-up. It's really lifting off, feel the tension, or hands on the temples, but remember, not hands behind the head. And we're just lifting up, engaging the core, and feeling that pull through the core, through the abs in particular. Okay, straightforward crunches. You can do it really slow, or a little bit faster, as fits you, okay? There's the standard crunches. The second one was the diagonals. Two ways of doing it. We can either go from here, knees bent, from straight arm, straight across. They start off easy, but as you do a few, it becomes harder. Or if you're more energetic, you could go from here to leg up. Okay, as you wish. Just really just working the diagonals, working the obliques. Okay, this hand is either out to the side or off the side here. A comfortable position, or we're just reaching through. We get the same effect, that diagonal pull through the obliques and into the abs, into the abdominals. Same again the other side, down to the side, here, reaching across, or we can do leg up. Okay, depends on how energetic you are. Obviously, if you're doing leg up, then you're having a more of a pull across the abdomen. Okay, that's number two. Number three was the scissors. Lovely exercise, love this one. Two forms of scissors you can do. Now, locate your hands beneath your backside, and the scissors is either horizontal scissors or it's vertical scissors. Okay, so once again, feet around about 30 centimeters off the ground, a leg raised position. So scissors, horizontal or vertical, two forms of scissors. That leads on to the either what's called a leg raise or the leg iso hold. Straight leg iso hold, once again, legs or arms behind your backside again. So you can either do the leg raise or, as we did yesterday, an iso hold. And you can do iso hold with your back up, so you've got a semi crunch, or back down, as suits you. What I like to do with these is preload with a few leg raises and then go into an iso hold, and the further up, they call that a dish. Okay, so different levels of intensity, from the straightforward leg raise to a full dish iso hold. Okay, so moving on. Leg iso hold, then we do some dorsals. Once again, old exercise that's come back into fashion. The dorsal is basically a dorsal raise. So we've been doing some really great exercises. This is a straightforward dorsal raise. And what Michallis has been doing is you start off on the ground and you're going up and down. Up and down. Then we've been taking on variations from there. So we've got the T dorsal. So we're going up, out, in and down. All right, clubs are in the way there. Up, out, in and down. That's the T dorsal. Then we've got the Superman dorsal. So we go up, out, change over and down. Up, change over and down. Up, change over and down. That's the Superman dorsal. And the third one is the Y dorsal. So we're going up, splaying out, in and down. Up, out, in and down. So we're making a Y shape. And the last one we did in the floor exercise is a press up. So I can get rid of the mat for this. So just to recap on that last one, so the dorsals, if I show you them from the front, just before we move on. So we go in, imagine us on the ground, we're going up, a T, or we're going a Superman, or we're going out to a Y. Obviously my chest will be on the ground. Last one, press ups, either short lever, knees on the ground, or long lever, okay, as normal. And the standard press up is with my arm here, or my palm below my shoulder. That's a standard press up. Slow and deliberate is better than fast and cutting corners, all the way down, all the way up. And we also did some wide press ups. So here it's under my shoulder. If I go wider than my press up on both sides, I'm activating different muscles, all the way down, all the way up, all the way down, all the way up. Because the way my shoulder works, when I'm in narrow, that works well. When I'm working out to the side, if I move my arms out and splay them a little bit, because that's if I try and go wide that way, then I'm restricting my movement. If I splay out a little bit, then that's a little bit more natural for the way my shoulder operates, okay? A little bit of technique on that. We can also do narrow press-ups, different muscle groups, either they're called a diamond press up or just narrow grip. It's a bit harder, you're working more the chest and the triceps when you do that exercise. And once again, the adaptation for you is to do it on two knees. That's a short lever press up, but bear in mind that's a press up, that's not a press up. That's it's a bit of a waste of time actually. So if you do it, it's better to do 3 or 4 or 5 proper press-ups than 20 or 30 not so good press-ups. So think about technique and proper form first before we go for increasing the number of reps. Anyway, that's it. That's a weekly roundup for myself and Michallis. That's all I've got to say, apart from, in the words of the old song, be young, be foolish, and be happy. See you soon. Cheers.